Ned Yost didn't get ejected. Renteria did. I got an issue with a couple of things here, but let me ask you, Frank, the bat flip, was that over the line by Anderson?
Old school, that's over the line, but there's a new slogan in baseball, let the kids play. Ever since the bat flipping has become a big, big topic of conversation, all the guys are bat flipping now. Tim, yeah, it was a little much, but this guy has a little Ricky Henderson in him. I've been around him. I'm just telling you, he's an explosive player. He's five tools. He's very talented, and he plays with emotion. I mean, when he plays like this, he plays great. But if he comes the ballpark down, he's not the same player.
Right, he's leading the American League in hitting.
In hitting.
Heard him say.
He's a great young player. He'll probably tone this down just a little bit, but I see a little Ricky Henderson in this guy because he can do it all.
So, but this isn't we're playing in the modern times here. Yeah. What he did, do you have a problem with his bat flip?
I didn't have a problem with it. And listen, I side on the old school because that's when I played. I respected older players that lent that message to you and understood when you were one of the teammates, one of the 25, you protected your own. I don't mind what Keller did today because you saw how the situation was evolving. Yes, there's history of it. I didn't mind the way this played out today. But if you look at Tim Anderson, 264 career hitter, as you said, Chris, this is a guy that's had a very hot start. And I don't mind him showing those emotions and being able to expose that. Why? Mm-hmm. Because if you look at the World Baseball Classic, the emotion of the game, it needs that. It needs that energy in the game of baseball. And when we see the World Baseball Classic and everyone's playing, you got the music, there's a lot of noise, it's enjoyable baseball to watch.
And younger fans like to see the emotion as long as it's not so disrespectful. But we've seen this from Anderson before, Frank. Should one of the veteran teammates work with him a little to say, you can still be yourself?
Not at all, because the game is all young guys now. It's not that many veterans around. Bottom line of this kid, he plays with emotion, he plays with energy. I'm sure Major League Baseball is loving this.
Do you think he should have been ejected? I don't.
No way he should be ejected. He's the one that got hit, and I think, you know, the way Keller hit him, it was very professional. Down below the waist, in the thigh, that's how he handled business. And bottom line for me today is, you know, Tim Anderson is a new breed star, and you got to get used to some of this stuff.
Yeah, Joe West was the crew chief. I think they discussed it, and Anderson was part of that when you think about it. I don't think he should have been ejected. But listen, this is a situation where it got handled,
nothing.
Now, if a veteran wants to discuss it with Tim Anderson, it's in the locker room, and that's an important conversation as well.
Other side of things for the Red Sox, the defending World Series champs, only the Marlins have a worse run differential so far to start this season. Again, it's very early, but I think we just assumed, Frank, that both the Red Sox and Yankees were going to go to the postseason. Do you still believe at this point with what you've seen that they will both go?
Let me be a politician here. I think it's possible, but the way the Red Sox are playing right now, I don't think they're going to get
it. You think they missed in the Yankees?
I think the Tampa Bay Rays are for real with that pitching staff of theirs, and they're 8.5 games back already. I mean, it's hard to play the rest of the season trying to play catch-up. We saw the Dodgers do it last year, so anything is possible, especially with two talented teams of this caliber. But I see two teams out of this division make it to the playoffs this year.
How about you?
Well, I look at all three of them making it, and I'll tell you why. I think the division is down a little bit, especially with Toronto and also Baltimore. Those are our winning series, so they're going to take advantage of that. Plus, I look at the American League, and I think there's definitive winners when you think of the Astros in the West. And also, I would say Cleveland's probably the guy you have to knock out. Minnesota might be challenging. But there's also other teams that drop off. The Central is very weak when it comes down to it. I still think if you're going to challenge them, who's better than the Red Sox if they get on a hot stretch? And who's better than the Yankees? The Rays are not going away. I have to agree with Frank on
that. All right. So we know Yankee injuries. What about the Red Sox bullpen?
Well, the Red Sox bullpen, to me, is one of those, where's Kimbrel? Because that is what you have to look at. But, Frank, you've seen it. They've had some challenges early in the season.
I think Craig Kimbrel's sitting back relaxing right now because the teams need his services. He's still going to make the right deal because this guy's a dominant closer, and five teams need him right now at this point.
And you think about it, too, Chris. There's so many teams that if you don't have a definitive closer, they'll say, you know what, we don't really believe in that. We're going to give other guys opportunities until it rears its head right here. I think that's a worry when you don't have that consistent factor that you know those last outs are going to be made and you're going to win those games.
Boston with the third worst bullpen ERA in the American League. And we'll check on the Rays and their great start a little bit later, show you how they did.